you are deep in the belly of the Castle Grounds workshop right now. And today we are going to be working on our Husqvarna YTH22V46. It's the orange lawn tractor that you see at every Lowe's and big box store from New Jersey to Vermont, maybe even to California, don't know. It's a very common lawn tractor. We've owned it for, this is the third year. It's pretty good. No complaints. It's got the 22 horsepower Briggs & Stratton hydrostat, I think.
Yep.
Mows fine. There's one lingering problem, though. They should call it the Husqvarna backbreaker, or the Husqvarna handy capper, or the Husqvarna sterilizer, it's painful to operate. If you had an enemy and you put them on this lawn tractor and you made them ride it for 2 hours, they would come back and tell you every secret you ever wanted to know. It's a torture device. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to upgrade that with a very universal, common, adjustable tractor seat. You can get them at you can get them on Amazon, you can get them at Tractor Supply. You may even be able to get them at Lowe's. They're about $100, more or less. And we had an extra one lying around. And so we're gonna try to take off the old, very painful seat and upgrade it with a new one, and hopefully improve our quality of life a little bit by giving this thing a more comfortable ride. Now, some of you may not notice how painful it is, but when you've got 10 acres to maintain, and we really only mow probably half of it, it wears on you. When you mow every week for multiple hours, boy, it's brutal. So let's go through the steps of getting this thing upgraded, and then we'll do a test drive, test bounce. We're just gonna try it. So this is it. This is how it comes from the factory. You've got a high density foam, some sort of vinyl polyurea coated seat, mated to a hard plastic backing support piece, bolted directly to a thin piece of sheet metal, and it bounces on these, on these stiff springs. I mean, it's not good enough. So I think what we'll be able to do is just take the factory seat off. We'll use this existing seat pan and we'll modify it to accept the new seat base. I think it's gonna be pretty simple. Might need some hardware, maybe some welding, I don't know, we'll see. First things first, take off the old seat. It's only got two bolts holding it on. 9/16. Then you just slide the seat all the way forward. There's a release opening in the base plate. There's a tab that you have to, like that. And then the wiring on bottom, this is for your safety switch. Oops, there I go, I blew it. So I broke that. We'll probably just jumper this. By that I mean, the way this works is when it senses weight, I don't know if it connects to ground or completes the circuit on the power side, not really sure, but I should be able to connect two of these wires and then we won't need this anymore, because I don't really want to mess with the safety switch. Now, if you have small children that are going to operate your machine, you probably want to think of a way to incorporate this into your new seat. This is only operated by me, Henry, or my wife, so I don't got to worry about, you know, someone getting hurt, I guess. But if you've got a 12-year-old that's mowing your yard, one, congratulations, that's awesome. Two, think about that before you do this. It is a safety feature.
She's light.
This can absolutely be done attached to the mower. Because it's raining and I'm sweet and afraid I'll melt, I'm gonna go ahead and take this factory base, seat base off and do the modifying inside. It's just two bolts, but you could do everything you want here. I'm just gonna whip these off real quick and then we'll do it inside. Always have a nut rounder handy. It's my favorite tool.
So this is as hard as it gets. Factory pan, new tractor seat base, the entire mechanism will just slide onto here when we're ready. So all you have to do is attach this base to the factory seat. Now, there's 16 different ways you can do this. I originally thought that I was going to just run some bolts and nuts through here, and you definitely can, but what I'm seeing is a lot of the spacing where my mounting points line up, and I could drill holes if I wanted to, it's kind of not falling in line with where there's a flat surface. So probably what I'm going to do, and this is gonna shock you, I think I'm just gonna weld the sucker on. And you're probably thinking, weld it on? What if you need to take it off? Well, here's the thing. I'm never going back to that old seat. I will go buy a brand new mower before we do anything with that factory setup again. So really got nothing to lose here. The seat, the new seat can't be less comfortable. And in this way, it'll be sturdy, nice and solid. Won't wobble, and then I don't got to worry about finding the exact right size bolts and nuts, and because there's clearance issues on the bottom, you need to make sure they're not too long, not too short, blah blah blah. I'm gonna grind it and we're just gonna melt it together. You know why they call these cheek pokers? Well, do this without safety glasses on and you'll regret it. All right, we're just gonna clean this up. Firing up the old Deco Pro. Gonna find my baby, gonna hold her tight. Yep. Gonna get some afternoon delight. My mama's gonna want a great train. Till the middle of a cool night. Professional. I should have measured. Eyeball rule. All right. I'm liking what I'm seeing here. Go ahead and bring these across. Old Henry, fire up the air compressor. Well, we're at trying to make a video over here. That's alright, no one's listening. These are 7018 rods. Running off my Amazon Deco Pro welder. At 111 amps on a 110 volt circuit. Or 110 volt receptacle, sorry. I bet that ain't going anywhere. We got a little rod left. Let's go ahead and button up the back. That looks good. breaker. We tripped the breaker.
Oh, I did?
Yeah, well, you got the compressor and the welder done.
And the welder.
Okay.
Let me unplug it. Sorry. You're on. Okay.
All right, so to disable the safety switch, apparently all you have to do is grab one of these four connectors and yank it out. Give me some room to work here. There we go. That's it. No more safety switch. That was kind of scary how easy that was. We'll tuck that away so it doesn't get flop around. There, that'll be fine. Okay. Now it's dangerous. All right, the welds are cooled. We painted it space gray because space. I think it's ready. Now this new tractor seat should just slide on from the back. Don't scuff up the paint, y'all.
I'm in. All right. Slide around and get ready.
Ready. Wow, look how high that is. That's kind
that
of
is high.
Sheesh.
Well, you might still cut some of these off.
Well, sit on there and see what that feels like, because that looks high, but maybe it's not.
I don't know, Justin. I don't know.
You definitely got.
Can we go farther back? No.
I think that's the farthest back it'll go.
Where's that lever?
Don't slide off the tractor.
Up or down?
Up. Oh, boy.
Right there. That'd be good enough.
No, you're not locked in. You're about to fly off the back.
Okay.
Maybe we shouldn't have eyeballed it, Henry. Maybe we shouldn't have welded it on and we could have moved it.
Mm.
Or we can drill a hole for it to lock in right here.
Wherever it needs to be.
Yeah, so we can just drill a bigger hole.
Yeah, let's just do that. That might be better. Because I think right there.
And your weight's right over the springs there, so.
Yeah.
All right, we can try that. We'll drill a hole. Did you figure out what your weight was in kilograms?
Nope. I weigh 171.
What is that in kilograms?
I don't know.
All right, we're gonna make a hole.
I might go to sleep in this thing. Hey, that's not bad at all.
Okay, so we made the new hole as far back as we could.
It'll just stay there forever.
We should have just brought the mounting bracket back about 3 inches.
Yeah.
But I think that's as solid as it would be in the forward position.
Sit down. You comfy?
I feel like I'm leaning forward a little bit.
Yeah, you are. Yeah. That's why I say maybe take one.
I think we need to cut a couple coils off the springs,
yeah.
Get a more flatter ride.
I think that might be better.
Okay.
I'll take a couple off.
Let's cut a couple coils. So the problem now is when the seat is down, it kind of leans forward. So we're gonna cut a couple coils off each one of these springs and let it sit a little more flat, relaxed position. Cut off 1 1/4, 1 1/3-ish coils off each one. Whew.
Much flatter. Sit on it. See what it looks like. That's good. That looks a lot better.
I bottomed the sucker up.
There you go.
Still got a little lean.
78 pounds is what a 171.
Kilos? Kilograms? Well, you sit on it. I don't want to make it for my weight because I weigh a lot more than you do.
Hey, this is perfect.
I mean, it wouldn't take nothing to cut it again if it needs to be flat.
No, it's fine. I'd rather be up a little bit higher than two lower in the back.
You sure?
Yeah, we're fine.
Okay. Sit back down on it. I want to get a close-up of that suspension. And now stand up. Oh, yeah. You've actually got some.
You got some give, don't you?
Now we need to adjust the...
Oh, the...
So for your weight, you were 78 kilos? So we twist this. Am I going the wrong way? Yep.
Yep. There you go.
So the bottom is 60, the middle is 90, so 75 should be right in the center.
As of both of them.
Or the lower quarter, I guess. So probably right about
there.
Let's try that.
Yeah, you can tell.
The real test is going to be mowing for 2 hours and then standing up and seeing how you feel.
No, that feels comfortable. Because the other one, you didn't bounce at all, man. Not really. This one, you can feel a little give to it.
What in the world? Where do these come from? Was it?
I didn't see it.
Oh, it might have been inside here. Inside the bracket. Because we had that part outside. All right. I think that wraps it up.
Job down.
One down, 6,427 to go.